Nil, Secretary, Science and Technology Council, IIT Kanpur, to present ma'am with a small plant on behalf of IITK. Manish and Nil on stage.
Mathematics, physics, chemistry, and I'm sure all of you, the favorite subject would have been this, where we felt learning in school days, we felt very difficult. Why all these theorems, starting from Pythagoras to all type of theorems and laws, it was very difficult at that point of time to understand. But today, when you are doing the engineering itself, you know what is the meaning of those, what it means to science and technology. And similar is my way of journey also. As said, great opportunities were given by the school on the study tour to the Tumba Rocket Center, seeing the sounding rockets, and those were the only rockets available at those times, and seeing the satellites of different oceans, not the knowledge as today what is around, but that in somewhere in one corner of the mind, that feeling is was there, that something inspiring and something which is not experienced is there, that curiosity, what we call. And that is how after the 12th standard decided to go for an engineering, where I could get into the electrical engineering, where we were given options of learning some of the electronic subjects, because electronics were just coming in, and subjects like electronics and basic electronics were introduced to the electrical people. Plus, when we were in the fourth year, we were given the elective options whether to take mission design, for electrical mission design, or radar systems, television engineering, something like that. So, somewhere way out of 53 students, 3 to 4 students chooses to go for the radar systems, and I was one among that. And we had radar systems by Skulnik, the book, as a Bible, because we were told that you will not get, because 3-4 students, the no professor will come, and Trichur Engineering College didn't have a faculty for the radar systems. From professor from Trivandrum Engineering College will come and teach us that once in based convenient to the professor. But still, knowing little bit about the radar systems, what its applications, and if you get to know, it is for military applications. Somewhere in the nerve, it is there. It is for defense applications. And I think I take up challenges wherever it is difficult, somebody says, I feel like learning more about it. So that is how chosen that subject and then gone through it. And I, from the university, we have Trichur as well as Calicut, REC Calicut then. All comes under the Calicut University. I was the topper for the radar systems, because the challenge is given. So that is how I used to learn, and even today I can say, if you turn the pages, what after this, what chapter is coming. So that is, with that interest I learned the subject, and then DRDO advertised for a, after the engineering, there was an application, the paper for M.Tech in guided missiles. To be frank, at that point of time I was not knowing much about missiles. Only knows it's something which is followed as a trajectory and projectile, things like that. Real applications, real meaning of missiles were not known. But again, with the my curiosity in my mind and the field or the advertisement what has been given for defense applications, where again I chose for writing the entrance test for that. Same time I have applied for HAL, BEL and every other opportunity, what is DHEL for electrical, whatever possibility we have filled up the application, but somehow one among the 10 students selected by the DRDO, I happened to be there, and they started my, landed over to IIT Pune presently, and taught on the subjects which was again each topic, missile control, missile aerodynamics, missile propulsion, all were totally new. And with again the challenge of learning from the books and whatever is told for 1.5 years we have learned there, and that started the career towards the missile technology. And completing that course, we were to come and get posted to DRDL, then at Hyderabad. And like it was a transition between our selection for UPSC and our own DRDO recruitment. So there was a 1 year gap for me. So I got an opportunity to be in ad hoc and be in the institute teaching as a faculty member. So whatever I learned through the MTech, it got thoroughly revised with my teaching experience. And then I came to DRDO 1 year after that. And Dr. Kalam was the director of that lab. I did a project on non-gyroscopic inertial navigation system. Basically, if you have heard anywhere, you would have read that inertial navigation system works on based on both gyro and accelerometers. I have taken up a project which was non-gyroscopic inertial navigation, which one of the paper during my studies, we have seen a paper published by the Israelis on this. It's a hardware which has to be, a signal processing unit has to be, hardware has to be made on a rotating platform where the accelerometer is mounted. You will get the linear acceleration in three axes. If you rotate the platform, you will get a rotational angular acceleration from which you can get back the body rates, which actually the gyros does. So it was again a challenge within the student 1.5 years to get a hardware realized. That was the time when we are talking about, we were just using the computer card systems at IIT Pune. And I know the challenge in getting my project completed. One article is there as the support, which I was mentioning. And then with lot of mathematical equations, they are just given here and there. To derive the equations, it was running into pages, and somehow with my guide over there in DIT. And I never gave up the derivations and attempted that maybe the second semester onwards. Within that second semester, I could solve all the mathematical part, so understood what is being indicated as some equations, and then took up the project for hardware realization. A signal processing unit, again the hardware, getting the IC chips and making a multi-layered PCB at that point of time. It was a task somewhere, the guide itself said you can choose another project if you wish to. But I couldn't give up. It was something I felt that I should complete, and it happened. And from IIT Bombay, professor was my external examiner. And I think he said in his life he has given the top mark for this evaluation to his professor Sahasrabuddhi. So that is how the learning part of mine, I never used to give up as part of learning, came over for the work. My experiment even at DIT, I was interacting with the DRDO scientist at Hyderabad. Well, this hardware unit what I have made has to be tested in a laboratory. That facility was there, and that is how it was. And it was then after many a times taken as a project report, feasibility to implement in missile applications and things. It is an applicable solution, but only thing it's occupy space, a rotating system. Today we have many compact systems, motors which can be used for doing that. But science as it develops from a dynamically tuned gyro, that is DTG based gyros, which is bulky, to today we have MEMS based systems and RLG based systems which are lighter in weight and compact. So accuracy has doubled in 10 times with the inertial systems itself. So there was no looking into that. Came and joined. The day I came to DRDL, as usual, like Dr. Kalam asked, what is the project what you have done? So he said, I have done non-gyroscopic inertial navigation. So he told me there are 50 odd scientists in inertial navigation group spending their time working on gyros. Why don't you go and teach them? I don't know, a spark, like it is an inspiration or motivation. You feel that you are somebody great who has done a great job. So he tells and sends. Those are the few words of motivation. What sends you and then goes to the division where when you see the great scientists who are working on inertial navigation from where in which I've learned a lot and my whole career on the inertial navigation guidance and control. The journey started at that point. And we were working on Prithvi and then Agni. Parallelly, these two groups were formed. And initially, I worked on the Prithvi type of navigation and guidance. Very quickly, the Agni group was formed and I was moved to Agni group. We were working on systems with liquid propulsion system based guidance as a technology demonstrator, first by DRDO. Then we worked on that, logics which were available world across, like if thrust has to be terminated, we need to cut off the fuel supply or the oxidizer supply. That's the logic what we used to use. Then we see it is so complicated, the liquid system is so bulky, complex, and it cannot be stored. So there are a lot of problems. And the discussion was how to eliminate the, and we were able to achieve a range of only 1000 kilometers as the demonstrator vehicle Agni. The discussions, yes, from the very beginning of my career, I had opportunity to be in the discussions of mission design and guidance. So then there was a requirement involvement of developing a solid rocket motor. Solid rocket motor VSSC had used for their stage boosters, but again their terminal phases or the upper stage guidance was through liquid propulsion system. So nowhere in the country this type of logics or guidance designed for a solid rocket motor base. And I was given the task of designing a guidance law for a solid rocket motor. And I must say, admit that was my tough job in the career, because nobody or our expert scientists there, nobody could accept that such a possibility is there. Yes, world across talks about some thrust, physical thrust termination, cutting off the rocket motor. That is not the thing, because we are looking for an accuracy of the level termination velocity. If it differs by 0.1 meter for Agni 5 class of systems, you will be away by 4 to 5 kilometers from your predicted trajectory, which is not acceptable for us. So, working on that, I think I had the biggest learning curve in my career for Agni 2. We were asked to develop on that system. And there weren't much scientists to help around. We were all very few in numbers. And within 2 to 3 years' time, we have come to some mathematical solutions, guidance and all. And I was called for a review. It starts morning at 9 o'clock. And the whole country, experts from all over the country, from ISRO and wherever we could, because it's logical solution. So many professors from different IITs, Jadavpur, IAC, all were there, along with more than around 100 odd people were there in that conference hall, where in which I was asked to stand and explain the logics and guidance. It was to accept a system of that nature, because it's so critical. Designed for a guidance which will take you a nuclear weapon into another place. If something goes wrong, it is not that acceptable. But I still remember that lecture, I mean that technical discussion started at 9 o'clock. Somebody in the evening realized that I haven't sat not even a second, and continuously a working lunch was also served in between. So nobody realized that the person who is standing and explaining is not even having food also. I think 5 to 6 o'clock time, Professor Posha said, I think we are not doing justice. This girl is standing and talking from morning onwards, we should give a break. And that later on, professor was telling, I needed a cigarette smoking break. That is why I realized I should get out. So even then, that was a type of involvement for the people who were reviewing as well as for the person like me explaining. That is the intent, content of the experience I am saying. Even neither I felt hungry nor they felt that they needed a break. Such a way we had a review, and then it was many such forums, and then finally it was accepted. There's a story that by the time I was married and all, Commodore Patel is here, and he was my MTech classmates. So he also had learned guided missile, same course, same subjects. So my son was 1 year old, so I was thinking I should take a transfer. He was posted at Delhi, so I asked for a transfer to then our project director Agni, Sri R. N. Agarwal. Anybody who knows, nobody will dare to talk to him. So, but somehow I managed to ask him for a transfer, and the director, everybody convinced, director was Major General Sundaram. He felt how difficult it is to stay away and all. He said, okay, I will agree. And then I was given a transfer order. But R. N. Agarwal sir was never convinced. He felt if she goes, what will happen to the Agni systems? So he went to Delhi one day and came back and told, you are not going. Actually, to be frank, I had already packed all my luggage were not much, and it would have been in another day or so I would have transported to Delhi. He came back and told, if you go to Delhi headquarters, being a guidance designer, you will be reading newspaper and wasting your time. So I have decided you are not going. I do not know how to cry, how to react, because all prepared, mentally prepared to move out of that place. So, but again, came back to the seat and don't know what to, not able to talk, not able to, and there was no mobile phones to call up husband and say that I'm not coming. So it was a great moment of agony, and I don't know what to say. So it was very difficult situations, sometimes personally also I was feeling. But then I thought for a day or so and then said there is no other choice, because once PD Agni that time decides, it doesn't happen. So better give up all those things and stay back in Hyderabad. And that is how the life started towards then. There is no getting back on thinking of neither technically nor personally any challenge. That's how I was. Then immediately PD Agni has moved me to the project, so that I am not part of the lab to apply for a transfer also through, it has to go through him only. So that is how I moved to the project, and then we had flight tested Agni 2, then Agni 1. That was another challenge, that a single stage rocket motor and doing the guidance in the atmospheric phase, and we have done Agni 1, which has a capability from 300 kilometers to 700 kilometers. Agni 2, 800 to 2000 kilometers. Agni 3, again for a 3000 kilometers. Agni 1, 2, 3 is a special class of the technologies what were known to us. And 50 ton, almost 49.8 ton is the all-up mass, lift-off mass of the Agni 3. and we were able to get a range capability of only 3000. When you compare the world across missile classifications, they talk about around 35 ton achieving 3000 class, 3000 kilometers. And I was again called because I work on mission trajectory, simulation, control, guidance, overall system knowledge. So was asked why this is happening. Looked at systems and Agni 2, we had a first stage rocket motor coming from, initial concept has come from VSSE. So it had a thrust vectoring with by a secondary injection fluid. That is a strontium perchlorate. It is highly corrosive, so storage, every effect is a very complex control system with multiple valves to be operating. So it was a concern for the user. User also expressed that this system field worthy and storage life is critical, handling is a difficulty, why don't we look for a better system. Altogether, the thing has come how to design such a system. And I was told you change one of the stage of the Agni 2 and convert it into a flex nozzle control system. That is solely by the thrust you can flex and control the system. Why not that? So I started with that, configuring it as into A2 prime, that A2 plus or something like that. But when you work out, there is no comparison to the world across. They talk about launch mass of 35 ton and achieving 3000. So where in, I said, is there an option to go for a complete configuration change? Yes, as just being designated as project director, world across doesn't know. We don't have a project sanction. So I had the freedom of configuring. By then, learned the configuration design and missile design per, as a, all systems. So we worked out and then gone for the Agni 4. It's first of its kind in the country and with a composite rocket motor casing, wherein which the benefit of weight reductions were with a metallic composite 15 CD6 composite rock, metallic motor to this composite. The weight reduction benefit was of the order of 40%, and it enhances 1 kg of weight corresponds to almost 2 kilometers of range enhancement. If I am less by 1 kg, I will get that benefit. Similarly, the overall total from top to bottom, and looking at all the technologies, we were with, as I mentioned, the mechanical gyro based navigation systems, then switched over to RLG based systems. Total design change was suggested, and from missile top, tip of the missile to bottom of the missile has been totally changed and designed, and with 22 ton as the launch mass could achieve a range capability of 4000. That is what Agni 4. So I was the project director, started from top to bottom. So many a times our senior with experienced people were used to ask, is it possible? Because when I go for a design review, somewhere lot of questions, there were a lot of challenges. Every element of it has become a new. So taking up, we thought of going for composite rocket motor from the first system onwards. 10 years passed, no one wanted to touch on that technology because it has to be established. And to establish a rocket motor, we have to go through at least 3 consecutive testing, ground testing and prediction of the thrust profiles, and then take it up. So a mill of it is 5 to 7 years. I think that was again a challenging phase for me. Onboard systems, onboard computers. We were at 8086 system based to start with in Agni demonstrator, and by the time we came to Agni 4, power PCs and system on chip today for tactical missiles we are using. So that is a capability drive and total change. And once we have established a composite rocket motor in the upper stage, That was our technology jump. All the technologies what is required, low shock systems, anything what was required for a new innovation type has gone into Agni 4. So with that, within 2 years we could come to Agni 5, which was adaptation of Agni 4 to Agni 5. And then the country had seen the first of its kind of ICBM capabilities. And I have been a guidance designer for all the Agni class of systems, all Agni mission design. I think a heavy amount of load, and that is every day was a challenging instance. I must say that if a group of our scientists works, if a test case when the missile is integrated and testing is going on, phase checks we call it, phase 3, phase 4, different levels of check. The checks used to go for more than 16 hours. And I must admit, all my team was so motivating and spirited. Even if it is some problem comes, they would never tell, no, we want to go back, even if it is at 12 o'clock in the midnight. They'll say, we'll stay back and solve it and then go. There are people, instance, where scientists were working throughout the night and morning, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock, going back. Because the requirement is there, they come back again back by 9 o'clock, back again to the office. That is the type of commitment it was when we were working, because first time proving something, it is something. If engineers take it, they take it so to the heart, and then solutions are, until the solutions are seen. That is the type of dedication that I had. And came through that journey of it, and Agni 4 and 5 have been inducted into the services, a lot of flight trials. Then came more than 4 years I was looking after Agni systems as director of the lab of Advanced Systems Laboratory, where all Agni systems, all underwater submarine launch systems, rocket motors, all the composite structures, motor, nozzle, all the systems were coming from Agni. And then came the opportunity to move as Director General for Aeronautical Systems. So today I am looking after all the airborne systems like LCA and its variants, the unmanned fighter aircrafts, UCAP, and unmanned systems, UAVs, then the Nirbhay class of systems, that is cruise missiles, subsonic cruise missiles, that aerial unmanned aerial targets where for different applications, then the aerial delivery systems the aero engines, indigenous engine capability by GTRE. These are all things which is coming under my view, all the aeronautical systems. And the systems which is like surveillance systems, that is AWNC, early warning radar systems, based radar based systems. One of those systems, AWNC systems, participated in our court also, Eye in the Sky, which has given you the view of what has even not happened. And that is the level of right now the commitment or things. That is my journey of aerospace. I thought I would like to share with you. And I think this being an interactive session, you are most welcome to query upon.
Audience for ma'am.
Okay, so we have a hand there.
My question is, I have seen many mothers after having a child, they sort of stop their career. How was their experience like? How? What suggestion would you like to give to them?
Yeah, it's a really a difficult time period for a mother. Like even I also thought of taking a transfer, as I said, but destiny didn't allow me to go. But today the support systems are there. That was the time when I was working, hardly 5 to 6 women scientists were there. And there was no crash facility, there was no, you won't find anywhere also that such facilities within the campus. So that was a time when you had to depend on somebody. And those time it was only 90 days, 3 months. As your leave period also when child, for the child birth. But today it has been enhanced to 6 months. You have further, you can take leave for 3 years looking after the, caring the child. There's so many options have come where in which you, it will not hinder your work. So that is one thing. And we have to have some support, that is what is required. It's again something what is your wish, like your own inspiration to do the job. If you want to give up, it is very easy to give up, that's all what one does. But mostly what we find, nowadays nobody leaves, quits the job because of child care or something. But there are a lot of support systems and this crowd which comes for the scientific activity, they are so committed. Even if you tell them you close down the computer, go back, we'll start working tomorrow, they don't go because the problem is there in their mind. So they would, that is the dedication and commitment it comes when it comes to a national flagship programs like Agni and Tejas and things like that. That is the dedication what it comes. And if like we are given an assignment, we will all complete it, no, next day by the time. So it is that type of feeling it is.
Hello. So I wanted to ask, what do you think is the reason that the number of women pursuing fields like science, technology, engineering, mathematics is much fewer than the number of boys? And also, what advice would you want to give out for this?
If you compare the days of 1980s, that was a 3%. Today it has grown up to 7 to 8%. That's only the engineering, not real engineers coming. The other jobs, women have come up, admin and allied jobs. This is, that's what I am saying. From, it has to start, the change if you are thinking, it has to start from our own home. Because we have to treat both girl child and boy child, that going for engineering. When I had opted for engineering, there were people within, neither my father or mother were against it, but relatives were telling, what will you do if she goes for engineering? You have to find a match engineering person. So you have to give so much of dowry. This was their concern, not for my parents. So that is the thought process where in which, that's the mindset or the bias we had. We are all grown up. Today also if you see the grown, I mean educated family also, it so happens. If the family is having dinner together, a boy child and a girl child is there. After dinner, the boy simply picks the plate and goes back from the dinner. Same thing if a girl does, the mother itself will tell, take the plate and keep it in the kitchen, in the wash basin. This is what, this all have to change. Only with the educated family and when you see. Definitely I would like being a working lady. Girl or boy, unfortunately I have only one son, but I need by himself. And if it would have a girl child also, I would have said the same thing. So that difference, if you don't give, the person will grow. That is the change what we have to bring. We ourselves has to be the change agents and think that what would happen the country's growth or country's development if all women are also working at scientific level. It's mere determination. That's yes, every journey of every career will have a difficulty, but you have to overcome the difficulty. The difficulty, you take it as an opportunity to prove yourself. Then it will happen.
So, as you mentioned, from Agni 3 to Agni 4, you had to make a drastic or radical change in design and configuration. So, I would just like to ask that what was, before convincing others, how did you convince yourself that this present model may not be feasible enough to continue our journey? So, what was the moment, could you share with us, when it came to you that, yeah, we have to change something radically?
Yeah, because as I said, Agni 3, we had 50 ton mass weight, all stages, two stages of rocket motors with maraging steel and configuration, 2 meter dia. So this Agni 4 is only base motor is 1.2 meter dia and second stage is 1 meter dia. What is 2 meter dia for the total system overall was that. To bring into that, it was a really technical challenge. So lot of effort, lot of reviews, interactions. Yes, some days I used to feel that why did I get into this type of, because it was very difficult to get accepted by people itself. And that composite rocket motor proving, going through the proof testing, pressurized vessel, so going through the testing, it was a real technology change. Because I wanted to have a system which is world class. And when we launched Agni 4, first flight, we did a 3,200 kilometers because we have range restrictions to send, this is also going way beyond equator. We keep two ships for monitoring and tracking the systems. So we decided that decision is up to the executive decisions. We tested 3,200 kilometers in the first flight. When we launched and Agni 4 was declared success, when we were having the media review, the Chinese media reacted and there was a lot of report saying that the system has better capability. They are not high because it had all the technologies. It's a world class system. I can vouch for it and it has done its job. It's again design and a group of team which has worked for it. I was only as a project leader. Rest of the things were happening, but ensured that no time give up. There were choices that go back to the old working model, but never gave up. That was working for designing. Got a chance to design the whole system. Yes, took it off. That's all.
Good evening, ma'am.
Yeah.
Am I visible to you?
Yeah.
Okay. Ma'am, I have two questions. First one, as you mentioned that you had to go to Delhi for as well in the mother phase. So you didn't go, but actually this shows that you have so much dedication to your work. Now we are going through such a crucial phase of life as a student. So I think that if I were at your place, I must have fled from there to Delhi. So how to develop that kind of dedication of work?
Yeah, sometimes it is good, as you know, see, destiny takes you to where you have to be. And maybe the opposition that I should not go, that would have given a chance. So it is all you weigh what at that point of time. It so happened because it was so difficult. In DRDL, if you know Hyderabad, there are DRDL is 15 kilometers away and RCA, new Dr. Kalam made a integration assembly lab for us, which was 15 kilometers away, and that was like a forest at that point of time. And we were living in that place. Every event I had to come 15 kilometers, and I was one person. I joined DRDO, DRDL in February 1988. By August, I purchased Kinetic One. That was the time Kinetic Honda was in great news, with girls in style form riding, you know, like it was. I got fascinated by that ad, and they said drive easy or something was there. I went without I knowing driving. I went and purchased Kinetic Honda, and I had an experience first day itself. Because I learned driving also. I went to the showroom and asked, I don't know driving, will I be able to learn this? Within 1 week, our own driver will come and teach you. The one girl came, that was the biggest mistake I made. Girl came, she sat beside me, her own smooth kind of one, because it is already done, it's all, it's different than the new one and the old one. Very smooth driving, accelerate, and she was holding my hand from the left side for the brake. So whenever brake was required, she was applying. I was only, my hand is there. So she, within a week, she declared that I am fit to bike, fit to drive. So, but I didn't have the guts to bring from Secunderabad to Hyderabad by road. I asked one of my colleagues only. He brought, Mr. Warrior brought all the way from Secunderabad to Hyderabad. And Chinese hostel, he came and parked. We used to work late hours that time also, the mission was going on. So we came, he comes out around 5:30, 6 o'clock. And the whole crowd left, we come for some tea break. At the time, he said, why not you bring the Kinetic Honda, the new one. And between that scientist hostel, there's a small slope for climbing, like, yeah. And I took the Kinetic Honda. The whole scientist hostel, all the scientists and the family were all clapping with their clap and all. I don't know, I came to the slope. And it's not going beyond. It just gave one little acceleration. My God, that vehicle jumped. Because it's totally new, I don't know. And I don't have any control on brake. Brake was, she was applying. So she was applying, so I never felt the brake requirement. But those days, I was, you know, half this size, very good at. People in my engineering college used to say I can beat PT Usha. So that type of structure I had, so I could easily jump out, but I left the vehicle and it went and hit the one pillar of the scientist hostel, and it was years together I used to see that scratch there. So that was my experience. Then I am literally shivering, so I said never in my life I will touch a vehicle. And but our colleagues, Warrior and Babru and all, very good scientists, they said, no, no. Babru said, I have 7 sisters and he is only 1 son. I have taught all my sisters driving. I didn't even tell them, because we were very shy to talk each other also, like any requirement. But then he said, I will teach you, you come. So somehow thereafter, for 1 month of very evening driving, long drive, there used to be 2 escort, both of them, one in the Yamaha and one in the, that time, Vijay Pushpak or some scooter. I was not able to know whether my vehicle is moving or not. Both the sounds were so high, you can't know whether it is going. I used to tell, and that's how I learned. That Kinetic Honda is still there with me in my garage now. So, never give up, that is my way of life, it has been there as per personal requirement or not. Because it was becoming a constraint that if you are not mobile, you are not able to work, like late hours of working, it was very difficult. If I say the story of why I went for Kinetic Honda is also that, one of the night I was coming out 8:30, generally those days there wasn't any question of hiring of vehicles, or one odd ambassador was with the directors. So it is at that level, never no hiring business, or like as we feel now, vehicle we need, there is no. And I was coming out from DRDL gate, there is a, it is a open NH road to our campus. While walking, I felt that some lorry was honing or something. I felt that lorry is following me. I started running, and those days we were few women in the campus. So all the security people used to know us, at least by face. One of the security fellow was calling me, saying, "What happened? What happened?" I'm not stopping. I just ran till I entered the campus stop. But again, still feeling, even though safe zone I reached, but still ran and reached home. That is how. Then I spoke to my brother. I said, "What to do? I am so scared. Can I buy a scooty or that time Luna?" Then he said, "Why Luna? Kaineti Honda." So Kaineti Honda already I was fascinated by seeing in the newspaper. So he also said, "Buy Kaineti Honda. It is very easy. You go for it." That is how I went for Kaineti Honda. So never give up. It's always opportunity which makes, and it is situations which make you to take decisions of
On that note, thank you once again, ma'am. May I now request Manish to present Dr. Thomas with a small token of appreciation on behalf of IITK. This elegant portrait of Dr. Tessy Thomas is a collage artwork created by our students Saurabh Suman and Joseph. May I now request Neil, Secretary Science and Technology Council, to present a small token of appreciation to Commander Saroj Kumar Patel on behalf of IITK.
Faculty, students, administration, likes of workers, and on my own behalf, extend a very hearty vote of thanks to Dr. Tessy Thomas for gracing this auditorium with her benign presence. Thank you. Ma'am, your views on the theme Be the Change were undoubtedly inspiring, and we hope that each one of us tries to imbibe the same in his or her life to a significant extent. I would also like to extend my gratitude towards the organizing team comprising of students, professors, and the institute administration staff. Promptness in action both on planning as well as execution level has led to the successful completion of top-down interactive session. At last, hearty congratulations to all of you for turning up and making it a productive one. Thank you. Thanks so much.